This video is going to be an introduction to quadratic functions. And what I want to do is see what they look like, see what some of the features of their graphs are, and also look at some equations of quadratic functions and see what we can understand just by looking at them. Okay, so here's a graph of a quadratic function. I've got my vertical and my horizontal axes. I've labeled the horizontal axis x and the vertical axis y. And I've got this curve here. This curve is called a parabola. And all quadratic functions will have the form of a parabola, a curve like this. So the parabola can either open upward, in other words, it can go up on the left end of it and upward on the right end of it, or it could also go down. It could be something like this. Over here, where both ends of it face downward. It doesn't matter where on the graph is it. It could be up in one of the different quadrants. Something like that would be a quadratic function. If I'm over here, it's a quadratic function. Okay? So let's talk a little more about the curve itself. When you have a parabola, if it's drawn properly, this is just a rough drawing, if it's drawn properly, you can take the lowest point, if the curve opens upward, like this one, or the highest point, if it opens downward, and draw a vertical line through it. And where that vertical line touches the parabola, we have what's called the vertex. The vertex is the place where the graph either goes from having a downward slope to an upward one, or if it opens downward, like that, the vertex would be, I wanted that to be dotted, the vertex would be where the graph goes from moving upward to going downward. Okay, so basically what you can say is that the graph of a parabola is symmetrical. And if we take that dotted line and fold the paper along that dotted line, the left half of the graph is going to touch the right half of the graph. So the line has a name. The line is called the axis of symmetry, or the line of symmetry, and basically just lets you see where the graph is symmetrical. Where the line touches the graph is the vertex. A quadratic function will also have a vertical intercept, this point right here. That's going to be where the graph goes through the vertical axis, and it might have two horizontal intercepts, as in this case, or it might touch the graph and just turn around again, something like this, in which case it's only got one intercept, one horizontal intercept, or it might never touch that horizontal axis. It might look something like that. So there's no horizontal intercept for this one. Okay, so you've got the form of a parabola, you've got a vertex, the line of symmetry or axis of symmetry, which goes straight up and down through the vertex. You'll always have a vertical intercept, and then you may have two horizontal intercepts, or one horizontal intercept, or no horizontal intercepts. Okay, let's look at some equations for quadratic functions. Here I've got y equals 3x squared minus 4x plus 7. And sometimes you'll see what's called the general form of this, which would be y equals ax squared plus bx plus c. And what this is telling you is that the a's, the b's, and the c's could stand for just about whatever number you want, except for the a. We'll have to talk about that a little more. But they could stand for whole numbers, they could stand for fractions, decimals, positive numbers, or negative numbers. Okay, so you can plug in whatever numbers you want in here. And this, once again, is called the standard form. Now, the b and the c could also be zeros. So in other words, if I had y equals 3x squared minus 4x, then that would be like saying y equals 3x squared minus 4x plus 0. So there is a c, it's just 0. Or what if I just had y equals 3x squared plus 7? Well, that's like saying that the b was 0. So I could plug in 0x to put it into standard form. You could probably do that mentally. You might not want to write something like that and hand it in as your homework. Okay, so basically what we're talking about here is, I'm sorry, let's go back to the A. The A has to be a non-zero number. You know, because if you think about it, what you've got here is this. If we get rid of that x squared part, you've got a linear equation. And all the rules that you have for x are going to hold true for x in a linear equation, are going to hold true for a quadratic function except for one. So remember, we can't have a rational exponent after the x. You can't have the x in the denominator of a fraction. You can't have the x under the radical sign. Now, when we add that x squared, we're also going to have rules for that. The x, you have to have an x squared for a quadratic function. You can't have a variable, an exponent that's higher than 2. You can't have x to the third. That's no longer quadratic. And once again, you have to have a non-zero number for the a. So a quadratic function is always going to have an x squared. It may or may not have an x. It may or may not have a constant, like the 7 or the c. It cannot have a 0 multiplying the x squared. Okay, so it's basically your rules for quadratic functions. And of course, you could rearrange these if you want to. You could make them look more complicated, but that's the basic form. Now, there's a couple of nice things about these. If you think about linear equations like y equals 3x plus 4, where the 4 is the b, y equals mx plus b, remember that 4 was the vertical intercept. Well, for horizontal functions, the last number, the constant that doesn't have any x, is going to be your vertical intercept. The reason for that is very simple. You remember, in any equation, the vertical intercept happens when your x value is 0. So if we take something like y equals 3x squared minus 4x plus 7 and plug zeros in where the x's are, all we're left with is y equals 7. So the c, the constant at the end of the equation, is your vertical intercept. The other nice thing that you can see just by looking at the equation is if the a, the number that the coefficient for the x squared, if that's a positive number, your graph will open upward. Both ends of the graph will be moving upward. You have a smile. If the coefficient for the x squared is negative, your graph is going to open downward. Both ends of the graph are going to face down, like a frown. Okay, so that's basically the first video about these. There's a lot more to say about quadratic functions, but I'm going to stop this one now and we'll go on to some more later. Take care. See you next time.